Thank you for tuning into Cornerstone Abundant Life Church YouTube Ministry with Apostle Terry G. Simmons Sr. Please like, share, and subscribe to spread these powerful messages from God.
Titus, the second chapter, beginning at the 11th verse. You know, I know most time in church we look for an intermission where the preacher going to his homiletics, whatever. I went to school too, but it's really about the Holy Ghost. Because we can go on and pick up what everybody else do and don't be led by the Spirit. I don't practice what I'm going to do when I come out. I just go with the flow. If he tell me to take off running, if he tell me to turn a couple of flips, I might hurt myself, but because he told me to do it, I would do it. But the church has moved away from what God has called them to be. We carry a holy Bible, but don't nobody want to be holy. They want to be Baptist, Methodist, Emmanuel, Church of God in Christ. Everything but what God has called them to be. But Titus said that we can live holy in this present world. I said, no, you didn't, Titus. He said, we can live holy, don't matter how the world is going. He said, be holy because your God is holy. He said, follow peace with all men, and holiness without no man shall see the Lord. So I found out that I should be holy. I should be dedicating my life to God. I should be consecrated to God for a religious purpose. I should be sanctified, set apart by or for God. So my life should be holy in spite of whatever you are. I love that. Because it separates me from church people. It separates me from Christian atheists that go to church, but they don't obey God. An atheist said there is no God. A churchgoer said there is no God because they continue to live as they lived before. But God's word said, told Nicodemus, you must be born again. He come back in 2 Corinthians 5:17, said, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Holy. Holy. Holy is his name. Holy. Holy. And if you ain't holy, you will not see the Lord. Titus, the second chapter, beginning at the 11th verse. It said, for the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodly and worldly lusts, we should live soberly, righteously, godly in this present world. Oh, Heavenly Father, in Jesus. God, I say right now, have your way in this place. Do whatever you desire to do, God. But have free course. God, I anoint my eyes that I can see wherever the demonic spirit you desire for me to see. God, I anoint my ears that I can hear directly from heaven. But most of all, I anoint my mouth that I will speak nothing of myself, God, but all that you give me to say. God, but your servant asks something else of you. That you anoint your people ears. That the way they came, they won't leave that way. God, right now, We need a word from the Lord. Right now, God, we need to hear from heaven a rhema word, a word that had not been passed around by preachers or passed around by the internet, but from you, God, because I know you still talk. And God, we forgive you the praise. We'll give you the thanks. Send your Holy Ghost in this place to rest, to heal, to set free, to deliver. God, but have free course. And God, if we ever give you the praise, we'll give you the thanks. In your Son Jesus' name we pray, and every heart can say, amen, amen, and amen. And you can have your seat. You know, so many times in the church, they be saying, man, y'all stand up too long. And I'm not knocking the Million Man March, but it's amazing how we can get all denominations to come together for a Million Man March to hear Farrakhan that don't even believe in your God. But I can call a Million Man March for Christ, and I couldn't get nobody to go. But we can get a million men to come together to talk about racist stuff. And we can't get 25 to come together and talk about Jesus. But I ain't mad with them. Because there's going to be more saved people in heaven than hell going to hold. So I'd rather be in that march. And I miss the Million Man March because I don't know if I'm black or what I am right now, because he told me I'm born again. So he didn't give me what color I am right now, but I love God because he got a sense of humor. But anyway, in Titus, I want to talk to you all today about you can live holy in this present world today. Because somebody had to live holy back then when everybody was still doing what they wanted to do. You know, Sodom and Gomorrah was back there. So you knew there was a lot of stuff going on back there. But somebody chose to live holy. And even though Peter and all of them ran with Jesus, they really didn't know him until they got filled with the Holy Ghost. And now we got people that preaching that's not filled. We got preachers that testifying that's not filled. We got people that saying blessing, highly favored, that hadn't been filled. And they got a little bird, they call them, what is it, a parrot, or which one of them remarked what you say? A parakeet. A lot of parrots in the church are just saying what they don't hear. But when you blessing, highly favored, you ain't got to have no money. When the Holy Ghost is with you, you just happy all the time. Now, it's not that you don't have a problem. You just know that the problem, turn it over to the Lord. Because he said, cast all your cares for me. Cast them to me, for I cares for you. But I'm going to get a little personal today, because no matter what age you is, he told you to be holy. And so I just want to talk a few minutes to y'all. In Titus, he started off talking about, for the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. So that means no one can say that grace and salvation hadn't appeared to them. So when every man stand before God and he die, before he leave him, God going to make sure he have heard his word. That's what I like about God. See, people go to church and they tell you that they don't took the right hand of fellowship in church, but they don't tell you they don't took the right hand of fellowship with God. Because God expects you to live righteous and stop making excuse for your sin. And so many times we are making excuse for sin, and they say, well, I got saved, but then they walked away from God. But man tell them now that, you know, once saved, always saved. And I understand that, but that ain't what the Bible said. 2 Timothy 2 and 4 said, no man that wars entangle himself with the affairs of this life. Said, no man that has changed and came to God entangle himself with the affairs of this life. He don't get caught back up with this life no more and the things of this life and start saying that I can't do nothing since I'm saved now. I've been saved for a while now. I still do things. It said that he may please him who has chosen him to be a soldier. He says, please him. You know, we get men going to war and they get trained by them how they supposed to conduct themselves and how to fold their beds or how to make their bed and make sure the bed got so many creases this way and so many creases that way. And then they pick that up and bring it back home after they retire. They deal with the higher rank and don't deal with the lower ranks. And we go by that if we've been in the military. But the only person that have a hard time trying to get us to do what he want to is the church. He built man in his image and likeness, but now we want to do it our way and not God's way. But you'll follow your boss. You'll follow your job. You'll do what the Marines said, what the Army said. But God have a problem with his people. And I don't understand that. And he said, to know ye not that you are the temple of God. He said, now you carry me. You house me. But I'm instead of talking to you and you don't want to listen. So you telling the Holy Ghost, I ain't got to do what you said. But he said, you can live holy in this present world. You ain't got to go out and be a scripple. You ain't got to go out and smoke and drink and hold mungo. You ain't got to be a liar. He said, you can live holy in this present world. He said, holiness or hell. He tell you, he mad with you. He said, holiness or hell. They don't talk like that in the church no more. Because they want everybody to think they're going up. But David says, y'all heard that song when David said, who shall abide in our tabernacle? Who shall go in our holy hill? He that walk upright and got pure hands, clean hands. He that has sinned not against his brother. Who shall? He said, know you not that you are the temple of God and that the Spirit of God dwells in you. That's only if you're born again. Now, all of us have a little bit of God because he said, he blows his and man became a living soul. So if you living, I know you got a lit dab. But with Christ, a lit dab will do. Real cream got that from God. Just a lit dab of Christ will do. You can't be the same with a lit dab of Christ. Now you might be all right with a lit dab of everything else. But not with a lit dab of Christ. He said, if any man defile the temple of God, him shall God destroy. And now people tell you, well, ain't nothing wrong with getting high. Ain't nothing wrong with drinking. Ain't nothing wrong with dope. They always telling me that. And I said, no, ain't nothing wrong with it. It's just what the five-star general said you can't do. He said you can't defile this temple. A God will destroy you. You ain't say I will destroy you. But now in the church, we can defile the temple, defile the church, defile everything. There ain't nothing going on. Everything is all right. But that ain't what God said. He said, but Terry, you can live holy in this present world. I said, God, I hear you. I know I can. I know I can. Because one thing God left, people ride off grace. But it's really mercy for a lot of y'all because you can't be under grace unless you're under truth. Oh yeah, we can't be on the grave without truth. You can't be on the grave without being born again. You mean mercy. God, thank you for your mercy. He said you get mercy every day. All us that's in sin, all us that ain't really confessing Christ and ain't living holy, you under mercy. Don't pimp grace. Because we use grace as a credit card to sin. Well, I'm under grace. And I'm under this. No, you just doing your thing. He said, if any man defile the temple of God, God shall God destroy. He said, for the temple of God is holy. Which temple are you? Ain't that something? And now God come to tell us today, you can live holy in this present world. So that means he know that it's possible to live holy. So now I'm asking you today, this morning, which temple are you? How you living? I heard you singing. I hear all that. He said in Luke 3:6, he said, and all flesh shall see the salvation of God. All flesh. He said, I ain't gonna leave nobody out there. All flesh shall see. But what are we gonna do with it? He said, you can live holy. And now we make an excuse. Well, do God expect us to live right? Do God expect us to really be holy? Did he really think we should be perfect? Yeah. 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 Said, be holy because your Lord God is holy. And now we're trying to do everything. He said, but for the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men, teaching us. We don't want to preach it, the truth no more. We want to talk about Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego. No, he said, teach us. Teach us that we ain't got to stay in sin, that grace abounds. He said, teach us. Tell these men that shacking is wrong. Tell them that drinking is wrong. Tell them that smoking is wrong. Tell them lying is wrong. Tell them that sinning is wrong. You ain't got to show your body to get a man. And then the first time a man call you a prostitute, you mad. But how they dress? You don't know a police unless you wear a police uniform. So prostitutes dress like that to draw men. So when you dress like that and a man approach you, don't get mad. You got on that uniform. But you can live holy in this present world. You can. And so many times we know how it go. He said, but teach us. Teach us. And we got so many men of God that going to school to be a preacher. Lord God, he told me that it's a call deal. He said, I will give you pastors of my own heart that will feed you with knowledge and understanding. Not write all what they think and then talk about it. And they shall be holy too. He said, teach us. You hear that? He said, it's teaching us that the nine ungodly and worldly lusts, we should be sober. Ain't that something? We should live soberly, righteous and godly in the present world. Now, this was back then when the book was wrote. And now the church has downplayed God's word that it don't have no power no more. It used to be powerful that people used to come to church drunk and leave sober. And now they come drunk, leave drunk. Ain't nothing changed, but God said, you can live holy in this present world. I'll tell you right now, don't put nothing on limitation on God. He said, it might be impossible for man, but with me, it all things are possible. He said, I can live holy in this present world. I'm talking about white, and don't even get dirty with sin. In other words, it's just like walking in a coal mine, and ain't nothing in there but coal with all white on. And come out clean. That's the way I'm walking around in the world. I'm walking around in all this sin and I'm still coming out white. Because God told me I can live holy in this present world. Now if you're limiting me, you messed up. You can't limit me. What you mean you can't limit me? He said in 1 Corinthians 6:20, for you are bought with a price. I already paid for you, son. And since you're up under the blood, the devil can't get you anyway. Because if the devil come through the blood, he won't be the devil no more. I got power in the blood. I still got power. That same power that was back there then is still there right now. Power, 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 power. And people don't want to be holy. I think it's some power to be poor or holy in this world, looking at all the sinners and all the churchgoers that go to church, all the Christian atheists that go to church, but he don't keep his commandment. He said, because if you love me, See, he got a thing. He got this. He got a side down, y'all. And people saying, "Oh, I love God. I just still got some habits." Well, okay, I got you. He said, "For you are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body." Hold on now. How can you be saved and not glorify God in your body? When he told you, present it to me as a living sacrifice. Don't give me the top part and still have your bottom part where you do what you want to. He said, present your body. And the body means this from all the way to the foot. You know how we want somebody to pray for us from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet? That's what God wants. From the crown of your head to the sole of your feet. He wants your body to be holy. I love him, y'all. And then you can be poor and broke and don't have a job and still be holy. See, that's what I like about him. See, you can't get accepted in this world unless you got something. You know, that's the way the world is. But with God, a homely man can make it to heaven. And here you got a mansion finna bust hell wide open. Because he don't need your money up in heaven. He got streets of gold, y'all. Y'all don't know that. Y'all like that when that's in the conference. Y'all don't like that when they're just talking. Right. But I love the way he explained this thing. He said, teach us. Deny ungodly and worldly lust. That worldly lust. Because we think we're in love and it's lust. Both spell with a, they start off with it. They just don't end up the same. It said L-O-V-E-L-U-S-T. But it got an S on it. Because lust is more. See, you can lust at anything. You can lust at a car. Ain't got to be a man. But you can lust at a man, and you are a man. Uh-oh. No, I know y'all ain't going out like that. Nah. But you can look at a woman and start looking at her like she fine. That's unnatural. Something got to be wrong. You ought to be saying something on the inside, working on the outside, because this ain't the way God meant for me to be looking at no another woman. And now I'm having feeling for a woman, and then when I look at a man, he look fine to me. No, none of y'all men in here look fine to me. None of y'all. He told me to follow peace with all men. He didn't tell me to like all men and look at them like that. But he said, I can live holy in the present world. I don't care if everybody becomes sisters and die. I ain't going that way, y'all. I ain't going that way. All y'all can switch out. Y'all can start looking at each other and all this and that. You can do it in the church. I'm still going to preach hell about you. But I'm telling you one thing. I ain't becoming who you is. I'm gonna let y'all pat the cake y'all on self. I ain't doing it. I'm gonna stay holy. I'm gonna stay dedicated, consecrated to God. Because you can't, you know, they got it now where they make sisters think they consecrated to God and dykes that they consecrated to God. You ain't consecrated to God. I don't care if you get a church and you can't paint the whole church rainbow. I don't care because Dorito got chips out of it all. I don't care if Coca-Cola got y'all colors and all that. You still going to hell. And that's not God. He said, be holy because your God is holy. And God ain't no sis in it. He called hell her. He called the church of him. He ain't even trying to put that together. Y'all don't want to live holy. He said, teach us the nine ungodly lusts. In worldly lust, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. He said, looking for the blessed hope. I'm waiting on the bust of scalp. They said one day he's going to bust a scalp and come in riding on the cloud. And that's some. All y'all been sinning. All y'all ain't got saved. Y'all going to see him coming on. He ain't no surfer. He just going to ride in on the cloud. Read Revelation. And every eye. See what I'm saying? You can turn your TV off. Cable can be turned off. TV coming on. Phone coming on. He don't got y'all set up because all y'all got phone. You can be in a commode. Your phone popping up. What's going on? Here he come. Why ain't he got y'all? He said, every eye, even them that pierce him, gonna see his appearing. Yeah. And now the church is, like I said, they on Noah. They eating, drinking, marrying, doing everything they want to. Every church now, all they got a concert, making money, preaching rich. Here, Kenneth Copeland. Here he got a $6 million house. How many people in the church could have had a house then? Huh? He got a private jet. How many people could have had other airplanes in his yard? And then he got a runway. He got his own private airport. And God tell us we won't preach for filthy lucre. That ain't holy. That ain't holy. I don't care. And they can say, oh, y'all, he just hating because he ain't got it. I got Jesus. I got more than enough. You can't, when you die, you ain't seen no airplane, no $6 million house behind no hearse yet. My name up in heaven. My spirit already there. He said, I make you sit in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. My spirit already in heaven. I'm getting paid more than any preacher now because I'm staying with truth. That's why people don't come here. Because I'm trying to preach hell about you, scare hell about you. I'm trying to tell you one thing, sin going to separate you from God. They telling you that you sin is okay and the grace. He says, should we continue in sin that grace abound? It said, God forbid. It ain't said Paul. It ain't said me. It said, God forbid. And we think we're going to stay in sin. I love him. I love him because he said, that's what he said in Psalm 107 too. He said, let the redeemer of the Lord say so. That's holy people. He's talking about let them say so. Y'all ain't said nothing. See what I'm saying? Y'all sitting there thinking y'all ain't holy. Y'all know where y'all going. Everything in here that ain't holy, you on your way to hell. Ain't no secret. I don't care what age you are. I heard my wife telling young men, y'all better stop following y'all wrong company. But y'all think it good. Y'all think because y'all get some twists, your pants sad, and everybody talking about you, who you is and who you ain't. He said, no man should get my glory. Is God getting into your glory? What you doing? Huh? When mama don't know what you're doing, is God getting the glory? Huh? When you're knocking them little girls off, is God getting the glory? Hmm? He said, he that knows to do right and choose not to, gonna get beat. I'm gonna punch him. I'm gonna beat him down. See, all y'all young people, y'all acting like y'all don't know what right to do. Y'all know what right to do. But it's gonna come a time, if you die in your sin, you just like anybody else. Gonna be hot down there. And don't call apostle. I'm just going to look over here. I ain't going. He said, looking for that blessed hope. I'm looking for it. I don't care if he come today. How many of y'all feel like that? Y'all don't care if he come today. Now, you can't say that if you ain't right. You can't say that if you ain't holy. You can't say that if you ain't living for God. You can't say that. Don't tell no lie. You are looking for him to come back, and you still got work to do. You got drunk in your trunk. You got everything. You still doing everything you were doing before you heard about God. Don't do it. Say, don't come, Lord Jesus. Tell him, don't come. Give me a few minutes. Give me a little time, God. I know I've been in the church for a while, but I heard them talking about being born again, but I ain't changed. I heard them tell me I don't need to be smoking and drinking, but I still smoke and drink a whole month and still had sex last night, smoke a little reefer every now and then. But God said, I'm going to get you. Well, God, you made the reefer. He made poison too. I ain't seen none of y'all drink that. Huh? And marijuana make you feel good. You just want to be cool. Well, how you know, apostle? Mm-hmm. He said, looking for the blessed hope and the glory appearance of the great God. Not just God, not just the great God. Because, see, that lit God, that lit G is the one that be fooling y'all to stay in sin. That lit G tell you got tired. He old. He apostle 57. You know, he tell us all the stuff he done did. See, he done did some stuff. But I'm 57. How you know you're going to be able to get there? Don't go off my schedule. Because everybody living to get 57. But holy, I might be 157. Huh? But I'm making preparation that whenever I go, whenever he call me, whether I'm on the commode, whether I'm in a car, because I'm telling you, people driving crazy. I turned right there at the corner, a lady on almost hit me in the side. Go up Jackson Street, a big old truck almost hit me in the side. All I said, Lord, I thank you. Because your hand, see, some of y'all might have had a wreck. I ain't even had to call Jesus. You can't touch this. I ain't talking about M.A. Hammer. I ain't talking about Hammer. I'm talking about what God said. You can't touch this. I got work to do. He said, I have a great Savior, Jesus Christ. He said, who gave himself.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God.
Y'all love John 3:16, though. For God so loved the world. We got that on iBox, on our Instagram, Twitter. We got that. We love that because he died for the whole world. But y'all want to go to 18. In the same chapter. He said, them that believe are not condemned. But them that believe not is condemned already. So that means you ain't got to wait to get to heaven to be condemned. All you just got to do is not keep loving yourself and not loving his commandment. I love God. I love him. I love him, y'all. And y'all get mad and all that. I don't care about him saying I'm too saved. Amen. He said, who gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity. Ooh, by the blood and power. He said that I redeem you from all iniquity. That means everything that could have got me, he already redeemed me from it. What? I'm saying, God, I appreciate you. Because when Terry ain't got the strength, you already said. Who wouldn't serve a God like that? And y'all let me lit G tell y'all a lot of things. You all right? God know your heart. I'm talking in this ministry. We've been hearing the word a lot. We got some scholars in here. We got some people that, the young people here can teach a theologian school. Right here. But they love the world. And the things of the world. Because the lust of these things right here. In this body, it craves for stuff that's not God. And it said the flesh and the spirit are contrary. One to another. They war. Every time you want to do good, the flesh said, come on back. Sweet Jesus. The flesh saying to you, come on back. Y'all know how I said, like Ella said, when you're your man or your woman be on left, and you get on the phone, you say, baby, come back. Baby, come back. That what God telling you right now. Baby, come back. Because if you stay where you're at, and the devil on the other side saying, baby, come back. Y'all won. Because you love you. This thing crave, y'all. You could be watching TV, minding your own business, ain't thinking about nothing. Hey, y'all know that all the commercials got panties on it. That's what y'all mean. You sitting there minding your own business, watching 300 hard help. Why you want to be a 300? You sitting there with you, yo, this shit going back that high. But anyway, the commercial come get you. That would keep your little shield down. Because the commercial come up with number panties on it. And y'all know the first thing we start thinking, whoa. We start, mine when he was there. You start, you know, grandma and them used to say, When grandma used to say, y'all know it was someone right. And y'all young people don't listen to the spirit. When grandma used to say, boy, that girl don't mean you no good right there. I'm like, man, she don't know nothing. Go on with your bad self. That what y'all said in the church when we telling y'all the world don't mean y'all no good. And now I'm start saying, Who gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar. What? And we got a problem where people said we go to church too much. We in church too much. But then nobody tell me when I was. There ain't nobody told me I was in the club too much, dropping it like a hot, patting on them girls, and the girl patting on me. Didn't nobody tell me I was in the church too much. Didn't nobody tell me I was having sex too much. Didn't nobody tell me that. Didn't nobody tell me I was working too many overtime hours. Didn't nobody tell me that. They didn't tell me that. But when I got saved, they said, you go to church too much. But when you do the math, it's 168 hours in a week. Count how much you get your job. Count how much you sleep. Count how much you talk on that tell a lie. And then go back and look and say, well, how much did I go to church? Uh-oh. Don't try to break the calculator now. Don't try to. You got a calculator on your phone? Calculate it. Then the church ain't helping the sinner no good because they give them an 8 to 9 service. 8 o'clock to 9, and they're on the beach at 10. You mean to tell me you love God? Well, what if your wife gave you 1 hour out of 168? I better not start talking about y'all wife. He said, you can live holy in this present world. But you know how to be. Change your mind. You'll change your life. You don't change your mind, you'll keep going after everything that you were. Because y'all can't tell me I ain't Stephen Wonder or Ray. I see some nice looking women. Fine if you want to call it, whatever you want to call it. But I ain't where I'm at. Because I don't change my mind. I hate to see women naked now when I used to like to see it. And no offense to what they want to do. We seen something yesterday. I told Deacon everybody naked. Everybody. But that's the way the world live. But if you stay in the world, you get drawn into what the world like. You know, you keep hanging around. You know, grandmama used to say, you hang with dog with fleas. Huh? You lay down with them, walk with them. See, y'all just tried to do the laying down. Talk on the phone with that dog. Everything. Y'all, see, y'all want to just say laying down because you say, I ain't laying down with no dog. I know how they say it. But you talking on the phone with a dog. He ain't talking about Bible study. And sure ain't Sunday school. Boy, the church get crazy, don't he? Says zeal under all, zeal under good word. He said, these things speak and exalt and rebuke with all authority. Let no man despise thee. I ain't let no man despise me. Y'all can stay, be whatever y'all want to be. I'm going to be holy. I just believe that because he told me in St. John 15 and 13 and 15, he said, greater love. He was loving me when I wasn't even, when the book was being wrote, I wasn't even there, but I was considered there. You understand what I'm saying? He said, greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for a friend. Huh? For his friend. You are my friend if. There the church go. There the church go. See, he said, if you do whatsoever I command you. And now y'all know the church ain't doing. We just look at him. We ain't even doing what he commanded us. So you ain't his friend. But I'm telling you today, you can become. Because he said, I need you. You need me. You can't get to heaven without the Son. He's telling you, you need me. I want you to be a friend. But you got to get rid of your other friend. You know how when you start dating somebody and they had a boyfriend, you said, now look, Is it going to be me and you? Me and you? Are you going to get rid of him? And if they tell you they're going to keep him in you, some of us will go for it. Well, let me testify. When I was in the world, I'd go for it. Girl, go and keep him. Ain't no problem, because I'm trying to get me about 25 more. We got a very good understanding. But when God, not only he's a jealous God, his name is jealous. He said, I don't want to share you with nobody, Terry. I want you to, the way I die for you, I want you to love me. Now, is you going to get rid of the devil? Are you going to divorce him? Are you going to divorce all your friends that you want were with, that were still clubbing and all this stuff? Are you going to get rid of them? God, let me think about it. What? He said, you are my friend if you do whatsoever I command you. Henceforth, I call you not a servant, for the servant know not what his Lord doeth, but I call you a friend, Terry, for all things that I have heard of my Father, I have made known unto you. Direct connection. You know what I'm talking about? You know what I'm talking about? Like AT&T said, reach out and touch someone. You can reach out and touch God, Jesus, and he reach out and touch God and communicate back through the Spirit to you what's going to happen. He done told me before, get up and go check your children's room. I get up and go check the children's room, the pillow and the bed made like somebody in there. And I sit there and I'm like, well, I guess it is. Spirit said, check. By six pillars. Position with some at the head. I'm like, okay. But I call them up because I know they sell them. This call means 2:30? Dad, no. And I don't lock the door where they left open. And Mac better go to sleep. He said in Roman, I beseech you, God telling you. He said, I intrigue, I beg you. See, y'all don't got away from the mess. See, all y'all head down, all y'all looking all around. Y'all ain't listening. But if you die when you leave him, God done gave you an opportunity to tell you, I don't want you unholy. We get so busy when God's word goes. But when we start singing, y'all happy with song. But songs ain't deliver me. It was the word, nothing but the word. And I tell God, let me down deeper in your word. Y'all don't want the word. Y'all want a rap song. Chick your back, baby, what do? Y'all want to hear something like that. But you don't want to hear nothing that's going to change you. Your little nasty soul. Disrespecting God's house like that. Because y'all got something else on your mind. But when you die, your family member got to cry about you because they know you're going to hell. He said, small and great. He didn't tell you what age and all that. He said, small and great. And just because they're still a baby, they didn't tell a lie. Oh, he was 12. He already in heaven. You can't find that in the scripture. He said, be holy because your Lord God is holy. He's telling you that. He said, I beseech you therefore, brethren. He's talking to the church by the mercy of God that you present this body, not your neighbor body. That's why I get so mad with church. Every time I turn around, they want to touch 7 people here, 8 people there, 3 people there. Run, turn 5 people. We wasting all that time running around. And then we sit down and say, touch your own self. Is you saved? Touch yourself. Have you been praying? Touch yourself. Are you really right with God? We run around touching everybody. We think that church. I can't find nowhere in the book where Jesus told the disciples, run around and touch everybody. He for to be an example. He said, have the same mind I got. And then we want to be so slick too. We don't want the children in church no more. And if there is a church, we let them play the game and bring a laptop. They got cell phones in the church. They're playing games. Make me so sick. And then your children can take a cell phone or a tablet and work it like it ain't nothing. Here I am, 57. Had to get a child to tell me how to get in this port right here. Oh, that ain't nothing. That ain't nothing. Oh, man, please. What? And I'm saying, like, Ah. They can pull up every singer, but they can't pull up none with the Bible. And I keep telling us, parents, we pimp our children. We buy them everything they want, but won't give them a Bible. Won't make them read. Won't make them do Sunday school. And then you say, you holy. Then the rest of them make excuses. Well, I ain't got no hum. He ain't said nothing about having no hum in there. He said, because he don't look at male or female. If you got it in there, he made you the steward. You ought to raise him. I'm holy, sanctified, holy, and I ain't just up singing and trying to get no shot at and all this stuff like that, because I seen the holiness church fool everybody with that, because they fooled me. When I came to church, everybody was taking off running. I'm like, dude, come on, it didn't take me about 6 months to get the Holy Ghost. I got the Holy Ghost, and I started looking at them like, hold up. That's the same person with cussing. Right. Holy Ghost don't move like that, y'all. I'm telling y'all, these people jumping and shouting, they ain't got no Holy Ghost. They might got castle, but they ain't got the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost don't operate like that. Holy Ghost is pure, man. I don't know why we do that. He said, but a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable servant. He said, be not conformed to this world. Again, be not conformed to this world. What we conform to? The world. Well, what you mean, Apostle Simon? In 1 John 2 and 15, he said, love not the world. That's why we can't be saved. Y'all think about it. Every time you really concentrate on getting saved, what happens? Especially as you sing them. Some all of a sudden, somebody like you. And he don't send them how you don't like it now. If you don't like no fat man, he don't see no fat man now. You can forget that. If you don't like no fat girl, he don't see no fat girl now. But you like a fat girl now, he send it just like you like it. Why would the devil send you something he don't get your attention on? I see the church don't got cry. Don't y'all feel bad? I used to be sick pack. I used to have sick pack and all that. 19 inch neck, 19 and a half inch arm. I used to be swole. I'm 57 now. Still look good for me, but time come when everything start changing. Some of y'all still can't get up with it. But let me say, love not the world, neither the things in the world. He said, if any man love the world, if any man love the world, if any man love his flesh, if any man love things, he cannot love God. He will not love God. Ask yourself why you don't love him. Ask yourself why you ain't saved. Ask yourself why you ain't holy. Ask yourself why you ain't going after God wholeheartedly. Ask yourself, call my flesh. And look how he broke it down. The lust of the flesh is luxury. Somebody else get a new bike, and your mama can't get you a bike, you want to get you a package for a little while. I'm 18, my mama can't give me no car, I got to start doing something to get me a car. And they ain't getting out 2 weeks in prison now. I ain't heard nobody getting 2 weeks. I've been watching 48 hours, 48, what is it? In 48 hours, first 48 hours. Boy, they be talking about 58 years, 30 years, 62 years, life without parole and stuff like that. I'm like, man, please. He said, if any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world is the lust of the flesh, luxury, the lust of the eye, covetousness. Where you want something, somebody else got. Y'all young people, y'all know God is right, but it's not popular in school. It's not popular with your friends. So when I get to school, I lose my belt. And I got on me some Superman drawers. So I'm a sag, which I know when I get home, I got to tighten the belt back up. But I'm a sag while I'm in school. Y'all a girl? Y'all wear one outfit out the house? And got another outfit in the trunk of the car. Or you already had took it over your girlfriend's house the week before, because all of them were wearing some Dukes to school this week. Mama don't know. That's the way we do God. We covenant what everybody else do. Then it said, the pride of life. This is a disease of the ear. Of the world. Because what you hear the world doing, we got to do it, man. Come on, Clee. Come on, man, don't be no square. Let's do what the world do, man. God said, that's all right. This is how he said it. He said in Luke 8 and 21, a lot of us only are holy because of our family members. What you mean, Apostle Simon? He said, he answered and said unto them, my mother and my brother are thee which hear the word of God and do it. Y'all heard that? Everybody go to church here, but everybody don't do it. Like today, a lot of y'all sitting here, y'all ain't finna be holy. Because y'all got to give up some things. So y'all hear what I'm saying, but you ain't going to do it. You ain't my brother, and you ain't my sister. And you go to church with me. You ain't saved, you ain't living for him. He's telling you that. He come back in Matthew 12, 49, and 50, because that would happen. Family member, family member. He said, he stretched forth his hand toward his disciples and said, behold, my mother and my brother. For whosoever shall do the will of my Father. Y'all hear that? Do what he say. Obey his word. Because when you disobedient, that's sin. Amen. When you know the right to do it and you don't do it, it's sin. Amen. It separates you from being holy. Is anybody in the household? If we got anybody that can say I'm H-O-L-Y, can we say it? Because he tell you, holding it without no man shall see God. So I don't care what you is. If you want to tell me you Baptist, you want to tell me you Catholic, I ain't mad with you. He just said, be holy. He ain't talking about denomination, because I think denomination is demonic from the devil to keep the church separated. Because if we didn't have denomination, we could have a million man more. But since I'm Baptist and you Catholic, we can't get together. Since you Church of God in Christ, we got our own organization. He said we one body but many members. But that means the church can't be holy. Y'all didn't hear what I said, did he? He said it costs to be a disciple. He said, whosoever will do the will of my Father, which is in heaven, the same as my brother and my sister and my mother. He come back in Luke 14, 26 and 27. He said, if any man come to me and hate not his father. You know how your father might not be saved? They be saying, you go to church, my son. Stay home today. Dad, hold up now, Dad. We good now, but don't come against my father. You know, I'm spiritual now. You know, you fleshly and you ain't with God. So you really already my enemy, because anybody against God is my enemy. Now, I'm trying to be an example of light to you to get you saved. He said, and hate not his father and his mother, and his wife, and his children. Because you know, sometimes a wife and his husband mess each other up. Because where I want to pray and fast, that you don't want to pray and fast. Where I want to be in church, you don't want to go. You tired of going to church. You know, I know I'm talking to some of y'all. He said, children, brother, and sister. He said, yea, his own life also. You got to hate your own life to be holy. But you can be holy. That way he's telling you can't be holy. He said, he cannot be my disciple. And whosoever do not bear his cross and come after me cannot be my disciple. Now God said that. Amen. But y'all have put it on me. Thank you. This can't be the same church I heard all excited this morning. It can't be. But I'm coming on down. Let me look at the watch. You know, Oh, I heard Pastor, I'm good. I got you. Listen how God said it. He come back in Deuteronomy, the 30th chapter. Huh? He's telling us that this is what he expects. In Deuteronomy 30 and 10, he said, if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Lord, thou God, and keep his commandment and his statute, which are written in this book of the law. Huh? If thou turn unto the Lord, thou God, with all thy heart, with all thy soul, he said, now that can be a holy man. Are we doing this? He ain't through. I'm help y'all. He come back in the 15th verse of the same chapter. He says, seeing I have set before you this day life and good. Now God said, I set before you life and good. He's telling you, I'm putting it right before you. Why do we keep putting something that's bad? God told you right here, I'm setting it before you, Terry. I'm setting it before him. How did they get him in? I've set before you life and good and death and evil. Yeah. Huh? He's saying that I command thee this day to love the Lord thy God, to walk in his ways, and to keep his commandment and his statute. He said commandment and statute. And the church don't want to keep nothing now. They just want to have a good time. They just want to still be in their flesh. And then they'll tell you, tell them, be holy. They say, I'm a Baptist. Yeah. No, they don't know the book. The preacher didn't tell you, you're a Baptist church. But your temple should be holy. Amen. Y'all got that? He said his stature and his judgment. And thou may live and multiply. And the Lord thy God shall bless thee in the land where thou goest. Now come on down to 18 verse. Then what I said. I said, boy, I wish I could get in the civic center, get all the church in there just to tell them one thing right here. Come on. This God. He said, I denounce. Y'all got that? Y'all didn't get to Deuteronomy yet? Y'all can read with me. Y'all ain't scared. He said, I denounce unto you this day that you shall surely perish. He ain't said might perish. This God talking. So you tell me, we got people sitting up in the church with them big hats on and all that. They dead. Every Sunday, you go in the church, you singing in the church, you acting like this, but you ain't speak to nobody. He said, I announce to you this day, read, that you shall surely perish, sitting up in the chair with your little nasty self, same way where you were before you got saved. And I told you, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature, old thing, behold, all things. So how you still the old man? The old man can't be holy. He ain't holy. Huh? He can't be right with God. You look at God said it. He said that you shall surely perish and that you shall not prolong your days upon the land. Whether thou go, thou pass over the Jordan to go to possess it. I have called heaven. Hold up. You call who God? I call heaven. Enter. In other words, he said, I call heaven just to make sure your name got blotted out. I'm calling earth to tell you I'm killing you right here. I'm talking about all of that ain't holy. He already done called heaven and told him, get that name out the book. They said, you can't get blotted out. One save always say, go to Revelation. He said, I take your name out the book of life. If you add or take away anything out the book, he said, I call heaven, talk to me, Ella, and earth, to record this day against who? You. Against who? You. Against who? You. So that means you can live holy and against you. He ain't talking about no neighbor. He said, I call heaven, not a package deal, not a collective deal, not a church deal, against you. Anyone of y'all that ain't holy, it's against you. Feel your name in the block. He ain't got to call heaven or earth against me. I'm going to live holy in this present world. World can flip upside down. Everybody can squeak butt naked. Everybody can be gay. I'm going to still walk around. They can say, look at that alien. I'm going to be an alien. Because I ain't getting butt naked. And I get tired of looking at that nasty body that look nasty. I ain't getting naked. Some of them need to put them bodies up. I ain't lying. It make you sick. I ain't playing. Y'all look at that 19th verse. I want y'all to really get in your spirit. Moses, I call heaven and earth to record this day against Israel, Egypt, Moses and his brother. Y-O-U. Ain't that a man how that spell Y-O-U and the U still come back to you? If I can't spell nothing, I can spell you. It's going to happen to us. We're not holy. But the message said you can. You. It's come again and said, God trying to tell you, I don't want to have to call heaven and earth against you. But I ain't prejudiced and I can't lie. He said that I have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. He said, now let me give you the answer. Since some of y'all in bunk. Since some of y'all can't read. Some of y'all don't understand what life and death is. He said, choose life. That thou, even your children. If I don't live holy for nothing else, boy, look at here. I'm going to live holy for my sons. That when they ain't right, that I can touch God and say, God, cover my son in his foolishness. Cover my daughter. Cover them. That's what I'm talking about. Be able to touch heaven on my child. If I don't do it for nobody else, I can do it for them. Going through life and missing what God wants. And all this book here, 66 book, and people want to say, well, some of the books are missing. You ain't did nothing with these we got. They give you 12 more, you'll lose your mind. God don't add no more to me. I'm having a problem giving them this little bit. I ain't even hit the whole 66. I might don't use the whole 66, but you go through the whole 66, these people stop coming to church. But listen to what God said. This is how powerful he is. He said, 2 Chronicles, this is our scripture. He said, the Lord appeared to Solomon by night and said unto him, I have heard thy prayer. I told you there's going to be a war room. And have chosen Cornerstone, this place, to myself. I don't care what Pensacola said. Pensacola just is wicked. Y'all let know how wicked it is? Pensacola can do whatever they want to do. People still go to church. You know, anytime you can go into church and you know the preacher's a sister or a child molester and you still take your children and you go there, you're crazy. And then soon he knocked your child out, you're going to talk about, God should have shown me. He showed you when he went to jail. Shit, what you mean, show me? What you want God to do, come out of hell and say, he's a sister? No. Y'all know a sister? You know that would get me? When I was in the world, I knew sister. And I wasn't saved. Now preachers try that, they don't know a sister. They tell me, I didn't know he was a sister. How you didn't know he was a sister? I'm saved, but I know a sister. And he didn't know a diet. They dress like a man. They don't take no revelation. He said, and have chosen this place to myself for an house of sacrifice. Yeah. If I shut up heaven, that there be no rain, what can you do about it? That's what he's telling us. I let the world have same-sex marriage. He said, I let the world have same-sex marriage because y'all churches didn't do nothing about it. Y'all got millions of people in your church. You got 8 servants. You getting all kind of money in the church. And y'all ain't said nothing about the same-sex marriage. T.D.J., Paula White, Juanita Banner, Ben and he and all of them ain't said nothing about it. Ain't said nothing. Ain't said nothing there. T.D.J., no, he was already, he can't say nothing anyway. His son or sister. What he can say? He said, if I shut up heaven and there be no rain, And if I command the locust to devour the land, or if I send pestilence among my people, if all the killing in Pensacola, and the preacher had a big meeting in Pensacola, and they got all the big six and all of them came together, and for to be trying to figure out how to stop, what, how can we stop the young people from killing? And I messed around and heard Channel 3 News. They finally had something on it. I heard the preacher say, we don't have an answer. I almost tore that TV up. Let me on now. It's Jesus, y'all. How y'all don't have no answer? He got all power in heaven and earth. And y'all tell me y'all don't know the answer? No, y'all ain't been called. He said, if my people. I love him right there. He said, if my people. He was telling me one thing. Everything living ain't his people. Because he wouldn't have to say if. But you can live holy in this present world. I don't care what word to go. I don't care how the church go. He said, but if my people, which are called by my name, no man can come to God except God draw him. So he don't draw you to the church. That's who he's talking to. He said, which are called by my name shall humble themselves. Pray. Ooh, God, you said it so good. Pray. And seek my faith. And the preacher's talking about they don't have the answer. Here it is around. It ain't changed. He said Malachi 3:6, I change it not. He tell you Hebrew 13:8, I'm the same yesterday and today and forever. He said, I ain't changing. I ain't changed the word. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves, pray and seek my faith, come after me. He said, seek ye first the kingdom and the righteousness, and all these other things will be added. He said, seek after me. He said, and turn, that's what's wrong with the church. He said, turn from your whoremonger. Turn from your fornication. Turn from being gay. He said, turn. He said, turn from your wicked way. All that stuff is wicked. Turn from lying. Turn from not paying your tithe. Turn. Turn from lying. We don't want to turn. That's why old people, they come visit the church and they don't want to join this church because they say it's too many young people. I thought God said I'll renew your strength as the eagle. Give you you. So why you don't want to be around young people? I know why. I heard people say that, you know, this is just how I am. Old people. In other words, they said, I ain't finna change. So if that's the way you preaching, that's how you, this is just how I am. Okay, I ain't mad with you. That's just how you go to hell. It don't make no difference. God ain't said, he told everybody got to change. He ain't put no age on it. Y'all children better start getting some sleep at night, eh? He said, turn from that wicked way. He said, then will I hear from heaven and will give their sin. And heal their land. And the preacher was asking, how do we stop this? It's right here. Get your church to stop being wicked. Get your church to humble themselves. Get your church to pray. I told them on the radio, my number is 850-292-1393. Call and tell me one church that you know having prayer. The most powerful tool God done gave us. I'm talking about prayer, not a prayer conference. I'm talking about where everybody coming to get down their faith praying. The most powerful tool that we got is direct communication with God, and the church don't pray no more. They don't even have a Bible study no more to teach no more. Sunday school, they talking about a group thing. And then you got people teaching them in Bible study and Sunday school that ain't even saved. Because the preachers just want to hear paycheck. If y'all want group things, give you 12 him, 8 him, 4 him, 5 him, and then the person that over, you know they ain't saved. It ain't going to be in here. I want the usher saved. I get tired of going to church where the usher look like Pitbull. You come in there, they looking mad. Sit right there. God. Sit right there. Well, what if I just go on back out the door because you don't turn me? Huh? I don't understand that. He said, now my eyes shall be open and my ears attentive unto the prayer that is made in this place. Boy, that's a good thing to hear God say that the prayer shall be answered in this place. I'm like, God, you're awesome, man. He come back in 1 Peter 5 and 6 and 8. See, I ain't got no eye. I'm saying, I'm just saying what the word said. He said, humble yourself. Therefore, under the mighty hand of God, humble yourself. Get up under God's hand and just sit there. You know, let him put a hand on head and you just say, I'm under God. World go crazy. I'm humbling myself under the mighty hand of God that he might exalt you in due time. He said, cast all your cares upon him. For he cares for you. Y'all see, he said, if you're holy, I cares for you. You can stop a train if you want to. You know, I used to be a mason. And so they said, certain way you can stand, you can stop a train, you do all this and that. And that's what they said. But I found that most masons, they ain't saved. They go to church, and the emblems and stuff give you the symbol of God. But most of them masons be going with each other wives and going to a convention where the wife can't go because the wife can't be a mason. But the mason can be an Eastern Star. A woman can be an Eastern Star, but she can't be a mason. So when we used to go on trips and stuff, the wife couldn't go. It's no different from when the preachers go to convention. And they live on the sixth floor and the girlfriend on 10. And they tell wife, I'm going to sit with the preacher. Mm-hmm. Mason ain't the only one do some. I believe that alone. He said, cast all your cares upon him, for he cared for you. He see, when you're holy, he said, be sober. He ain't talking about drinking. I'm a sober in the spirit. He said, be vigilant. Because your adversary, the devil, is trying to get you every time. I'm talking about holy people. The devil don't have to bother people that just go to church. Because he know they'll come in church and just sit in here. Like some of y'all just sitting here, all y'all doing is touching your phone and trying to see when get almost to one. But I ain't mad with you. You have that same watch or cell phone to hell with you. It just ain't going to do you no good to see what time it is because it's eternal. Your battery can run out, whatever time to stop on, you ain't got to worry about time, never again. When you get to hell, your cell phone ain't going to work, because all them jokers down there that was with you, you'll be able to talk to them. There's just going to be a lot of hollering. He said, as a roaring lion, walking about seeking who he made a vow. He come in 1 John 5 and 4, he said, you are God's little children and have overcome them, but greater to be holy. He said, greater is he that is in you. See, he come back to you. You can live holy in the present world because you're going to be greater. Y'all hear that? He said, than he that is in the world. Everybody telling you, man, you don't get to do nothing. You don't get to enjoy nothing. But they're going to be burning. You're going to be walking on streets of gold. I'm going to have me on pimp walk up in heaven, y'all. Y'all can say what y'all want to. I'm scrolling. When I get ready to see Jesus, y'all can say what y'all want to. I know y'all can say, oh, man, what are you going to be doing there for the CG? That's just where I'm going to. I'm saying, boy, I've been waiting to see you so long. I'm going to be scrolling for him. Now, y'all ain't got to scroll to get the devil. Y'all going to be hot. Y'all going to be running. You ain't going to have no scroll. You're going to have to get there. But in heaven, I'm going on that goal. I was saying, Lord, I made it in. Thank you, God. I went through all that trouble and down on earth. They talking about me, all that. But look at him. Where's Jesus? I ain't looking for mama. I ain't looking for dad, auntie, sister, brother. I ain't looking for Paul, Peter, John. Show me the one that died for me. And I got a scroll for him. By the time they give me my crown, I'm throwing my crown down. I might throw it down a little too early. Hey, I'm in now. And all y'all get to the door, he said, depart from me. Y'all can tell my apostle just made. I went to chat with him. No, you ain't go to your apostle. Let me on in, Lord. Don't slow me up for them back there trying to talk that fool. Mm-mm. He said, then he that's in the world, but you can't live holy in this present world. Laugh now, because once you die, you won't be laughing if you ain't right with God. I can laugh now because I'm making preparation to make it in. Because the same man prepared heaven, prepared hell. And you have to make preparation to go to either one. What's your choice today? You can't go to heaven not being holy. Well, where you get that from, Apostle Simba? In 1 John 3:10, he said, in this the children of God are manifest, and the children of the devil. This is how he said who the children of the devil is. Whosoever do not righteousness is not of God, neither he that love not his brother. Y'all know that almost every church around here. You had to almost say 85% of the members won't go there.
Jesus.
How many of y'all? Which one do you identify with? Is you the children of God? Or you the children of the devil? Now listen how he said who the children of the devil is. Whosoever doeth not righteousness, is not of God. So if you're doing unrighteous, you're not of God. He said, neither he that loveth not his brother. How do you be born again, Apostle Simba? 1 Peter 1:23 said, being born again of not of corrupted seed, but of incorrupted seed, by the word of God, which live and abide forever. And everybody telling me they got baptized. Well, he said, sanctify them through thy word. Thy word, the truth, sanctify them. He said, sanctify them. That's how you're going to sanctify them. You can go down that water all you want. I know. I went down in it. Came up and was right back at the Bunny Club. Some of y'all don't know what the Bunny Club at. Well, y'all go there now. It's a little club. It's a little damn place, but it used to be the place then. But it got it. He said, by the word of God, which will live and abide forever. In 1 Peter 1:25, he said, but the word of the Lord endureth forever. And this is the word which the gospel is preached unto you. He said, it's being preached unto you right now. And for all that God has gave out as I come to a close, 2 Peter 2:20. He said, for if after they have escaped the pollution of this world, after God has drawn you out from the pollution of this world through the knowledge of his Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, they are again entangled therein and overcome. Y'all don't read it before when God said he come in and clean the house and get rid of that one spirit you have, and then you never did fill it with the Spirit of God, and then all of a sudden that spirit want a place to live, and he brings 7 more demons back with the one that he already had, and you couldn't even handle the one that you had. Now you got 8. And the number 8 means you got a new beginning with a bunch of demons. You got a new beginning. He said the latter end is worse with them than the beginning. Yeah. The latter end, it's going to be worse for you because you knew him. You knew what God expected of you. But you choose to go after things that were no good for God. Said the latter end is worse with them than the beginning. He said, well, it had been better for them not to have known the ways of righteousness. It's better for you that has not known the ways of righteousness. Then after they have known it, to turn from the holy commandment delivered unto you. But it has happened unto them according to the true proverb. The dog is turned to his own vomit again. That means you went back to after you heard what God said. And the sword that was washed to her wallowing in the mire. You can live holy in this present world.